See if we can get this Reggie rolling. Hold on now. All right.
We're going to do a beer review on both cameras, and we're going to compare the two. Hey, everybody. How you doing? Cheers to 17. We're going to do another beer review right now here live on the Jake and Eric Gaz. Why not? May as well. And we're going to do it on a dual camera. We're doing dual cameras now. We're going to start off with the Panasonic Lumix camera that's recording right now, right alongside the GoPro Hero 4 Black. And they're both recording at 720p. The GoPro's at 60 frames per second. I have no idea what the Lumix is recording at. Probably only 30, but not sure. Doesn't say. Anyways, we're going to go ahead and do this beer review. And we'll pour it up on the Lumix, take the sniff on the Lumix, and then we'll take the drink on the Hero. What the hell? What the hell? It's all for fun? Oh, here's the beer I'm going to try. The beer. Look. Let's look at the beer. This is from the WychWood Brewery. It's called Scarecrow Organic Pale Ale. That's 4.7% alcohol by volume. And this came in a gift pack that was so generously picked up for me by Dar of Jake and Dar. Organically grown English barley malt and a whole leaf target hops combined to invoke lazy, hazy days of summer in this sincerely satisfying golden harvest brew, brewed and bottled in the UK. Yeah. All right, let's pour this up and see what we got on here. On this lovely looking beer. Oh, not bad, not bad. Not a bad looking beer. Yes, it definitely is golden. It is golden. We've verified that the color is golden. And it's a bit cloudy, so it's not super filtered. Didn't get no head on it, but I got a cap. I got a cap right here. Look, I got a cap on it. All right. Let's go for the sniff. Oh yeah. I can't smell nothing. Sorry, but I tried. All right. Well, maybe there's a hint of beer? I don't know. There's not much aroma. Sorry. This one's not really brewed for aroma. There's really no aroma to speak of. I can swirl it until the sheep come home, but there's no aroma on this one. Let's go for the taste. And let's go for the taste. Cheers. See this one again? Oh, okay. It's kind of bohemian. It's kind of bohemian like. Reminds me of a bohemian wheat, like a light bohemian wheat beer. Is that what it's supposed to be? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. It's not bad. I mean, it doesn't really tickle me where I want to be tickled. But we'll talk about that on the next video. It just tastes like a light bohemian wheat style beer to me. Is this supposed to be wheat in this thing? I don't know. I get all kinds of echo from my bottle on through the microphone. I should get a rubber desk. I don't know, but that's what it reminds me of. Shame on me. Anyways, I'm not saying it's a bad beer. I think it's pretty good. I mean, for what it is, it's nothing to write. It's nothing to write your in-laws about. Hi, George. Did you say something? It's not bad. It's just kind of going on the meek. It's going, you know, the mediocre way. It's Hell, I don't know. It's easy drinking. It's light. It's got that sort of a, you know, it's got that European style Pilsner thing going on for me. But anyways, not a bad beer. I don't mind it. It reminded me a little bit of the Dr. Thirsties, the one I had there about a week ago from the same brewery. But hey, not bad. Not bad anyways. It's easy drinking. That's the main thing. And I think I'm going to go 3.5 out of 5 on this one. That's about where I'm going on this one. It's not bad at all. It's what can I say? It's not bad. Did I say that already? Oh, well. It's decent, to say the least. And that's where I'm going to go with this one. Cheers, 17. Keep your mugs full, and we'll see you soon. Bye.